We want to find the parametric equations of the line where the two planes given intersect. To get started, we want to identify a normal vector to both planes given. And if we take a look at the point normal form of equation of a plane that contains the point x sub 1 comma y sub 1 comma z sub 1, which has a normal vector n with components a comma b comma c, notice how when we distribute, the coefficient of x, the coefficient of y, and the coefficient of z give us the components of a normal vector. So looking at this first plane, notice the coefficient of x is negative 1, coefficient of y is 9, coefficient of z is negative 1. So a normal vector to this first plane, which we'll call vector n sub 1, would have an x component of negative 1, a y component of 9, and a z component of negative 1. Then looking at the second equation, where the coefficient of x is 5, the coefficient of y is 8, there's no z term, so the coefficient of z would be 0. Therefore, a normal to the second plane, we'll call it vector n sub 2, would have an x component of 5, a y component of 8, and a z component of 0. Now, if we find the cross product of these two vectors, it'll give us another vector that's orthogonal or perpendicular to both of these vectors. And this vector would be in the direction of the line of intersection. To visualize this, let's look at this graphically. Here we see the graph of the two planes. This yellow vector is a normal vector to the yellow plane, and this green vector is a normal to the green plane. If we find the cross product of these two normal vectors, we get this longer black vector, and notice how it's in the direction of the line of intersection. So the component form of the cross product of these two normal vectors will give us the direction vector for our line. Then we just have to find a point on the line, which should be a point that satisfies the equations of both planes. So let's go back and determine a point that's on both planes, as well as the cross product of these two normal vectors. So the two things we have to do is, number one, we have to find the cross product of vector n sub 1 and vector n sub 2, which I'll say will equal vector d, which will give us a direction vector of the line of intersection. And then step two, we also need a point that would be on the line of intersection of these two planes, which means we need the coordinates of a point that would satisfy both equations at the same time. Let's go ahead and find that point now. We know we'll have three coordinates. Let's begin by determining a solution to 5x plus 8y equals 8. Remember, this can be any point on the line of intersection. So notice how if we let x equal 0, we would have the equation 5 times 0 plus 8y equals 8. So we have 8y equals 8. So of course, y would have to equal 1. And now we'll find the z coordinate that would satisfy this equation when x is 0 and y is 1. So starting with negative x plus 9y minus z equals 8, we'll let x equal 0, so we'd have 0 plus y would equal 1. So here we have 9 minus z equals 8. Subtracting 9 on both sides, we get negative z equals negative 1, so z equals positive 1. So we can use this point when determining the line of intersection of these two planes. But we still have to find the cross product of these two normal vectors to find a direction vector for our line. Let's find the cross product of these two vectors on the next slide. We'll set this up as a 3x3 determinant. The first row will be I, j, and k. The second row will be negative 1, 9, negative 1. The third row will be 5, 8, and 0. To find the elements in this first 2x2 determinant, we eliminate the row and column of vector I, so we eliminate row 1 and column 1. So we have 9, negative 1, 8, 0. Next we eliminate the row and column of vector j, so now we eliminate row 1, column 2. So we have negative 1, negative 1, 5, 0. And finally we eliminate the row and column of vector k, which will be row 1, column 3. So we have negative 1, 9, 5, and 8. So vector D, which would be a direction vector to our line of intersection, would be equal to, here we have 0 minus negative 8, so 8i. Then we have minus 0 minus negative 5, so that's positive 5, but we're subtracting, so we have minus 5j. And then here we have plus negative 8 minus 45, that would be negative 53, so I have minus 53 times vector k. So a direction vector in component form would have an x component of 8, a y component of negative 5, and a z component of negative 53. This is the information we need to find the parametric equations of the line of intersection. And notice how they gave us x of t equals at. They gave us this for two reasons. Notice how the constant would be 0, which means they want us to use a point on the line when the x-coordinate is 0. Notice how we do have a 0 for the x-coordinate. And notice how the coefficient of t is 8, which would be the x-component of the direction vector, or a parallel vector. And notice how the x-component of vector d is 8. Any scalar multiple of d would work, but they're telling us that we want to use the direction vector with an x component of 8. So if we wanted to list out all three parametric equations using this point in this direction vector, x sub 1 would be 0, y sub 1 would be 1, z sub 1 would be 1, a would be 8, b would be negative 5, and c would be negative 53. So x of t, which I know is given, would be equal to 0 plus 8 times t, or just 8t. Y of t would be equal to 1 plus negative 5 times t, or just 1 minus 5t. And then z of t would be equal to 1 plus negative 53 times t, or just 1 minus 53t. These parametric equations would represent the line of intersection of the two planes, which we saw earlier is graphed here in red. I hope you found this helpful.